Hey everyone, Blockchain Bernie here with my latest episode. This one is about news in the Solana staking world, right? So as I've mentioned so many times, if you own some Sol, and you should, no financial advice though, just for entertainment purposes and, you know, for communicating my personal opinion, you should own Sol. And if you do own Sol, you should stake it, because otherwise you're just leaving money on the table, right? So you should stake your Sol. And there is news in the staking world, right? So what are the news? Let's just dive right into it. So as we see here, there is a tweet from Lane at StakeWiz. So Lane is the owner and initiator of StakeWiz.com. That's a very popular site. Here we have it that shows you a ranking of all these Solana validators. And he started something a few days ago and says there is a Jito relayer, right? So what is Jito? So Jito is the MEV platform on Solana. MEV stands for maximum extractable value. So with all these platforms that we have out there, there is also always an opportunity of MEV. So you can, it used to be minor extractable value. Right now it's just maximum extractable value. So in the case of Solana, the validator has the opportunity to order transactions in a certain way, and that way make additional income, right? And Jito is a great, great system that automates that, so you can be a searcher and search for, you know, opportunities for arbitration or similar things, and then you can ask Jito's block engine to send transactions as a bundle. And that bundle means it's executed atomically, right? So either all of these transactions succeed, or otherwise all will fail or roll back the ones that had already been executed. So this is a great platform that has gained a lot of traction already, right? So more than 50% of all the stake on the Solana platform is now Jito enabled, right? And Jito uses what's called a relayer, right? So their TPU, which is the transaction processing unit, is being rerouted to the Jito relayer. Then the Jito relayer does its thing there. It delays the transactions a little bit for 200 milliseconds just to give their Jito's block engine the time to take care of all the bundles and stuff like that. And then it forwards it to Jito-enabled validators to execute these bundles. So, but for that relayer, most of the validators, as Lane has found out, most of them, and us included, in the past, just didn't run their own relayers, right? What we really did is we just ran the Jito relayer, right? That's running in a Jito-controlled data center somewhere. And that just means that, you know, all 1,000 validators or so, or at least hundreds of validators that run Jito, they were all going through that same one relayer. And first of all, that has, decreased performance a little bit. But also, it is concerning with regards to centralization, right? And I thank Lane here explicitly to bring that up. That was on January 5th. And, then a lot of validator took that hint from him, and including us, and actually started to run their own relayer, which is a little bit of a technical challenge, but it can be done. So for us, for both of our mainnet validators, the active one and also the hot standby that we have, the unstaked one, and we switch back and forth between the two when we upgrade versions and stuff like that, both of them now run their own relayer, right? And that gives us more decentralization in the Solana world, and also it's helping the performance of the validator, right? So let's just look into what that means for the performance here. We're running our own validator. This is the Xandeum.com website. You have that that big fat stake here button here. So if you own your Sol and you should stake it, just go to Xandeum.com, click on the stake here, and then you come to this page here. You can just connect your wallet in the top right and then stake your Sol. It's the easiest platform out there to stake your Sol. And, you know, it has a super high APY, and we are one of the best performing validators, as we see here on stakewiz.com, right? So that's one of the pages out there that ranks all the validators. We are currently here number two. So we used to be number one for months and months. But, you know, right now our stake is quite high. It's listed as medium stake here, but it's above average, right? And the way the ranking works here on StakeWiz is like, if you have like exactly the average of stake among all 2,361 validators, then you get the highest points, right? The ones that are below average get a little bit of a penalty, and the ones that are above average also get a little bit of a penalty, right? So we're already getting a bit of a penalty because our stake is starting to be above average, which is a sign of our success, right? But, you know, it just means we'll probably won't get back to number one here by WizScore, just because our stake is here, and you see the number one has a little bit of a lower stake, but the APY that they do for you is the same here currently, right? So now if you look at some of the other validators here, like the number three grandpa stake, right? You do this, and then you see that StakeWiz is putting a big warning here, right? A validator is using a shared TPU IP or TPU relayer, for example, the Jito relayer, right? So this one's using the shared relayer, and that's not good for decentralization. It's not good for, and that can change, obviously, right? This is just a snapshot in time at the time of recording. But you look at the others here, like Coinsortium, and they have the same, right? They have that same warning. And you look at RareStake. Now, look at that. They have the same warning, right? And you look at number six, elitestaking.vip, and they have the same warning, right? So we are one of the few validators, and it was initiated by Lane. Again, I'm super thankful. Michael, if you're watching this right now, thanks again. And we're one of the few that have their own relayer running on the same machine where a validator is also running. So if you click on the Xandeum validator here, you see that we don't have that warning here, right? Because we migrated to our own relayer, right? So this is great news. Again, if you own Sol, you should stake it. The best way is just go to Xandeum.com. If you do that, you come to our main website, Xandeum.com. The link is in the description. It's also easy. It's right here, Xandeum.com. And you have that big fat stake here button, right? So you can click here, and then you come to stake-sol@xandeum.com. And you can connect your wallet here, and then just stake your Sol to, you know, one of the highest performing validators that we have out there, right? So I'll show you that again here, Xandeum.com. This is the main page, and you have that stake here button. You click here, come to this page, stake-sol.xandeum.com, and there you can stake your Sol with one of the highest APYs that are out there. Also, by the way, we went here into X, and I showed you the tweet here from Lane. If you go to our own profile here, Xandeum Labs, so this is our X account, and please, if you're not following us yet on X, please do that, right? So our name is Xandeum Labs. Please follow us there. And if you click on affiliates here, you see some of the team. So that's myself here, Blockchain Bernie. So please follow me if you don't do that. And we have Brad and Felix here also. Follow them as well, and follow Xandeum Labs, of course, also, right? So with all that said, if you like information like this, news about Solana staking, all the news from the blockchain world, and of course, our progress log, right? People love that. Our Xandeum community loves to get info about our progress as the Xandeum scalable storage layer. We have a points system, so join our Discord to learn about the points, learn about potential future airdrops that are coming, and just go to Xandeum.com. You can do everything there, and thanks so much for watching today, and catch you guys later. Bye.